Good evening. Welcome once again to the Haley's Lightning Sound Show. Tonight my guest will be Phil Thomas Katt. He's a local composer and songwriter from right here in Pensacola, Florida. And Phil, how's it going tonight, buddy?
Doing excellent. How you doing here?
It was my pleasure to have you on my show this evening. Tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, Phil is probably one of the most eccentric songwriters that we've got coming out of the Pensacola area. He seems to do almost everything right to make his music get over to the people that he cares to listen to it and everything. And before we start asking him some questions, I just want to read one thing that Mark O'Brien had wrote about Phil back in September of 1986. And it says, and I quote, "Phil Thomas Katt gets a lot of phone calls from people he doesn't know. And they're not necessarily calling to talk to him. Many just want to listen to his answering machine." In the past few months, he said the number, which is 476-6666, has been circulating among students and has been dialing it for quick shot of music and messages. Now, folks, I know this seems a little strange, you know, starting off the program right off the bat, you know, talking about something that half of you probably don't know what we mean. But I'm going to let Phil sit right here and explain to us just what is the KattLine.
Well, the KattLine, really, it's an accident. I mean, I started it several years ago. I just got an answering machine, kind of copying my dad, so to speak. And it took off. I just started doing creative messages with it, and before I knew it, it gained a following, mainly teenagers, but that's not all it is. And from there, it's just developed, and I decided, shoot, with the popularity of the KattLine, so to speak, I should release an LP, because I was doing music for years, and now's my chance to promote it to a large number of people.
I tell you, Phil, you know, since I announced last week that you was going to be my guest on the show this evening, I have literally had, I'd say, hundreds of phone calls. I know that seems unreal, you know, but really and truly, I've had a lot of younger kids, it seems like, when I say that, you know, in the adolescents, under 20, I would say, and it seems like they're calling constantly, you know, is Phil Thomas Katt going to be on your show? There's a mystique about you, I believe, that a lot of people, you know who you are by your name and stuff, but they don't really know who you are in person, you know, when they see you. Would you say that's a true statement as far as, you know, who's calling in on your KattLine and stuff, that it is young people?
Yeah, I definitely believe that it's probably teenagers. It would have to be. Because most of them, you know, I just know it's mainly teenagers because I listen to all the calls every day. But to give it a percentage, I would say a good 70% is teenagers and the rest are adults.
When would you say the calls are coming in, you know, basically to you?
In the afternoons after school.
After 3:30, more or less?
And on the weekends.
I guess that is a good barometer, though, right there to tell who actually is calling it.
Well, you can tell by listening to them also.
Mm-hmm. Since most kids know you don't get out of school to 3:30 or so. Let me ask you something. What comes first, the KattLine or your music, or you know, how would you describe that?
Well, I've been doing 45s for several years, and I've toured around doing, you know, shows here and there. But I'd gotten to a point where I really couldn't do anything more unless, you know, I got lucked up in a major label signing. And so I just sat back mainly and relaxed, and as a creative outlet, I started the KattLine, and it developed and grew, and it's what's taken me here.
No, I tell you, I've never really seen another artist actually go after, you know, and advertising themselves and promoting themselves this way. And you know, at first, when you sit there and you think about it, an answering machine, you know, coming on, you say, oh, you know, that can't grab, but so many people. And going back to the Mark O'Brien story right there, I believe it says in there that on Valentine's Day of last year, you had 3,000 phone calls. I mean, I bet that just stoked you more or less.
I mean, I listened for several weeks to hear all the calls, but yeah, I got a lot of calls that day. I've got another Valentine's dedication coming up this year also. I'm calling it the second annual, and I'm hoping to at least match that.
Well, great. You know, you was talking a few minutes ago that you've done lots of 45s. You know, I've done a few recordings and stuff. How many 45s have you done?
Well, let's see. I cut one that I would rather forget.
Well, I'm
several
sure
years ago, but that was Brand New Love. I've had Rockin' in My Chevy, a tune called Teen Lover, and then Hypnotized. And that had been the 45s. And from there, I put the album together with these particular cuts.
Mm-hmm.
And I cut several new ones.
Let me ask, would you say that an album is more profitable than a 45? You and I were talking before we went on the air tonight that that it just seems like it was that way. And if you wouldn't mind, please explain it to our audience.
Well, in my opinion, I believe a cassette, and that's what I press instead of an LP, is a lot more profitable than a 45 or even an album for that matter, because the expense is much lower in duplicating. And that being the case, you can sell it for a reasonable price and make a reasonable profit even on your first batch. And that's what intrigues me about cassettes over an album or anything.
You know, you've actually been a pretty lucky individual considering how much media hype you've gotten. I tell you, I've been around Pensacola all my life, and I've never really seen another artist, you know, that's had as much publicity as you have coming through the news media and everything. Uh-huh. How would you attribute, you know, your success there?
Hard work, just perseverance, and sticking with it. I believe people that don't make it are not those that didn't get lucky. I believe it's those that didn't try.
I hear you there. Well, first off, and I believe that that you can attest to this, that there's nothing easy about the music business whatsoever, and there's no for sure thing whatsoever. And I think that the only way that a musician can make it in this world is after you've been knocked to your knees 50 or 60 times, you still got to get up
uh-huh.
and do it again.
Uh-huh.
And there's no guarantee how many times you'll get knocked to your knees. And, you know, it seems like to me that you've really, you know, you've paid your dues and you've had a lot of hard licks dealt upon yourself and everything, but you know, it does me good to see you, that you still got your spirits up and, you know what your talents are and that you still aggressively go after it. And you know, that takes a lot out of a person, and it shows what a person's really made out of in order to do that. One other thing I want to get back to as far as what your records that you have, how can somebody purchase your records? Are they sold here locally?
Yeah, it's available at all the major record stores, to name a few, Record Bar, Sound Shop in both of the malls, and even the sound box behind the mall has copies.
Well, I tell you, see, right there in itself, having the Record Bar sell your stuff and the sound box, those are two of the most primo record stores here in the Pensacola area.
They've been very good to me.
And they don't deal just with anybody. And, you know, here again, it comes back to it. You've gotten the media behind you and your peers and stuff, and it's just very nice that the Record Bar and the sound box and all the other outlets that are selling your work, just seems to me that they're really doing the public, I'd say, putting out a good public service. Why don't we get to the phone lines? It looks like they lit up here, and let somebody ask you a couple of questions. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Tom.
Yes.
I love your recordings. I think you are so fine.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I'll call you sometime, okay?
Okay, do that.
Why don't you ever answer your phone?
I'm working all the time.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe you'll answer your phone one time when I call.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. Hey, we got another line here. Go ahead, you're on the air. Whoops. How about that? Let's take that one. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, I'd like to ask him if he thinks that this being on TV, if it just like makes a mysterious part of him like go away or something.
No, I don't think so, because I believe many of your mysterious artists, such as Alice Cooper and people of that nature, do television, and it's never hurt their careers. In fact, it's enhanced theirs, as well as movies enhanced Vincent Price.
Because I know at school a lot of people were asking me, is he really going to be on there and everything? Because it seemed like a lot of people wanted to see what you look like and everything.
Well, they could have bought the cassette.
Thank you for calling in, bud.
Bye-bye.
That's what we were just talking about a few seconds ago. You know, there is a mystique about you, and not to, you know, just keep pounding on it and everything. A lot of people know who you are by name and stuff, but
uh-huh.
they never really seen you, you know, face to face and know what you actually, you know, it's like you're not a real person more
uh-huh.
or less. Well, folks, he's definitely real. This is Phil Thomas Katt sitting here, and hopefully we're going to be seeing him on the big stage coming up pretty soon. Speaking of big stage and everything, do you perform live any, or are you doing any kind of live?
I perform live. I'm working now trying to organize a new band, and once I do that, I'm hoping to get out on the road again and start performing. Right now, I do solo gigs, and I do promotional appearances at rinks and record stores and things of that nature.
Okay, let's see. Let's take a phone call here. We'll get back to another question. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Yeah, how you doing?
All right, sir.
I'm wondering, your guest there, what do you do? You're riding in your car or something. You're thinking of a song, and you don't have anything to write it down on. You know, you can't. How do you remember it? Or like you
carry a cassette deck with you and record it.
Right.
That's the best thing to do.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much for calling in. Go ahead. You're on the air.
I'm a drummer. I just heard that you're looking, you know.
I can't hear you. I'm sorry.
Could you speak up, please?
I'm a drummer. I just heard that you were making a new band and, you know.
He's uh-huh. a drummer, I believe.
We can't hardly hear you. I understand you're a drummer.
Yeah, and I am forming a new band. Maybe he's interested in
it. Oh, okay.
Just contact me at the KattLine and leave a telephone number. I know everybody's going to do that.
Well, if you can't get it through on his KattLine, you can always call Haley's Lightning Sound at 432-2076, and we can definitely put you in contact with Phil. And
thank you.
And I'm sure that he's interested in any kind of local musicians around, as long as you're as dedicated as he is. And thank you for your phone call.
Yeah, I want to hold auditions on that, for sure.
You've done a video here recently, didn't you?
Yeah, we did some studio footage. It's not really a complete video, and it will probably be part of the complete video. But it's the guys that played with me on the cut that I'm pushing the most, which is Look At Me, is on the footage, and it's in the studio, just taped.
All right. We've got a copy of Look At Me right now in the studios. And, folks, I want you to sit back for just a couple of minutes here. We want you to view Phil Thomas Katt, Look At Me. That was a very, very fine video, Phil. Well,
thank you,
Harry. Let me ask, where did you do that particular video?
I cut that at Ty Bracken's place. We did it inside of one of his studios.
Mm-hmm. Who are the musicians that you have playing?
Ken Stitcher's playing the guitar. He's an excellent guitar player,
sure,
by
was
the way. He's with a band called The Ravens. And Ty Bracken is the keyboard player. He's also with The Ravens.
Man, I tell you what, that was excellent. Are you going to be doing any more videos in the near future?
Yeah, I'm hoping to in the next couple of months to do a complete video of Look At Me or one of the other songs, but probably it will be Look At Me more than
well, let's get back to the phone lines here and see what we got going on. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, I just wanted to tell Phil, hey, and that
hey.
I wish him the best.
Thank you.
And my sister and Deanna Simmons also says hey.
Well, hey.
Thank you very much for calling in. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, I'd like to know how many cassettes and albums have Phil sold in his career.
In my career, or just...
Thank you very much for calling in. Yeah, how many have you sold? I guess if you last, since you've only had the one album.
Well, just this cassette. Just this cassette. We're coming up on 500 copies of it since September.
Man, that is strong as acid, I mean to tell you. Folks, that doesn't seem like a, you know, Bruce Springsteen type, you know, quota, but I'll tell you what, around the Pensacola area for any local musician to sell 500 copies of their work is extremely well, and I tell you, believe me, you're going to be hearing a lot from Mr. Phil Thomas Katt in the near future coming up. We're going to try to get him to talk about, when we come back off this commercial break, about what his future plans in the recording business are and what he plans to do as far as live performances go. And we're going to take all your phone calls also. So please sit back. We'll be right back after this commercial intermission. Welcome back to the Haley's Lightning Sound Show. Tonight my guest is Phil Thomas Katt. He's a local songwriter and composer from right here in Pensacola. The phone lines are lit up. Let's take a couple phone calls before I put you on the spot again. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Hey, I just wanted to say hey to Phil and tell him that he's looking and sounding great.
Thank you.
This is Rochelle Hurley.
Hello, Rochelle Hurley, and thank you.
Thank you very much for your phone call, Rochelle.
Sure. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Let's take another hand while we get back to some questions. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, does it offend you when you get obscene phone messages?
It's according to how obscene they are.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, babe. Does that happen very often? Do you get a lot of, I mean, are they just crank calls?
Not from time to time, I do. But no, generally most of my calls are good.
Man, I tell you, it's, you know, this answering machine thing, I have a feeling after tonight's show, we're going to see a lot of artists, you know, really trying to do this thing. Let me say, you had a little bit of experience in the radio business prior to becoming a songwriter and everything, mm-hmm. did you not?
Yeah, I've worked in several stations. I worked at WFTW in Fort Walton Beach. Worked at WNBY. I had a short stance at MEZ. I was even out there at that station in Pace.
I hear you there. Well, I tell you, back in 1982, didn't you go to Nashville and you performed the Music City Awards that was up there?
Well, I didn't perform at that. I had an entry into that. It was a recorded entry. That's the way they do it. And I entered one of the tunes on the album called Look At Me, and it won one of the honorable mentions, and I was tickled with that.
Man, I mean to tell you, that there's literally thousands of contestants that enter into this thing. Is that all right?
Yeah, from what I understand.
And see, just to get an honorable mention, that's pretty tough by itself. Would you have any kind of clues or that you could give to the new songwriters that are coming out, maybe some of the young kids, you know, what it takes to get your songs published and how do you go about it?
Just perseverance is what I like to say, because I believe anybody can make it if they continue to try and not give up. Patience is the answer.
Do you publish your own music yourself, or do you have a
publisher? Some of my music has been published by national firms, such as Rockin' in My Chevy, which was on a single that I had.
So are you into, you know, like putting your music up there where other artists could record it and everything? Or
I haven't really pitched a whole lot. I intend to start doing that. I've worked up some packages, and I'm hoping to do that probably within the beginning of this summer. And I have several contacts that I'm going to use in that respect. I wouldn't mind it at all if somebody cut one of my songs. I mean, you know,
well, we
couldn't hurt a thing.
Let's move back to the phone line. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, yeah, I'd like to ask Phil when the next time he'll be playing live with his band.
Well, I'm
thank you very much.
Organizing the band, like we said, and I'm hoping to do that. You know, I have a couple of things that I could jump into in March if I get complete with the band, but I'm hoping by March. It could be a little later, but March is my deadline.
You got to admit, though, you're going to take your time as far as getting
the band members
and stuff to perform.
I'm not just
going to
hire
perform.
Anybody, somebody fresh out of lessons. I want a pro.
Absolutely. And you know, that's probably one of the hardest parts of putting a band together and everything is getting the right nucleus
mm-hmm.
to, you know, it takes everybody concerned to make that sound fat and make it sound so good that people would want to go out and see you play and
that's
stuff.
Right.
And I'm sure that if it takes you 6 months, that's how long you will take.
That's right.
If you can do it in 3 months, you'll do it then. So, folks, I guarantee you're going to be hearing from Phil Thomas Katt. When you hear wherever he's playing, please support him. We definitely need it. All the Pensacola musicians, you know, need to have people like Phil and all the other songwriters out of Pensacola. You know, we need your support, and we're definitely looking for it. Let's move on again. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yeah, I just have a question. If a guy like myself thinks he has ideas for songs and has written some songs that need a little work on them, but the basic ideas, I believe, are good, how could I sit down and talk with somebody to give them an idea of what I have and what my ideas are and see whether it's worthwhile or not?
I think the best thing to do is to record it on a cassette and send it to the particular person or persons that you're interested in pitching it to.
Record it on a cassette?
Yes, sir. That's the best thing to do. That's what most people listen to songs being pitched to them on.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Well, what about if you just
you have ideas for the words for the song, but you're not musically inclined. I mean, one that I have finished, I know that I could sing it, but it may not be the proper tune or melody for it. You know what I mean?
But I think what you should do in a case like that would be to put an ad in the paper for a composing collaborator. And that is the best thing to do.
For a composing what?
Collaborator, someone to write with you that can write music.
I see.
And we appreciate your phone call there, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Folks, I think what the gentleman's talking about also, it's called making a demo tape. You can go into a few of the studios around, like Haley's Lightning Sound has a studio, which that we own. You also have Soundtracks over on Jordan Street. They also do recordings. And you can go in there and do your own music, and it's called a demo. The studios can set you up with the proper musicians to play your music, you know, if you prefer, or you can bring in your own musicians to play it, you know, themselves. So you do have a few options that are opened up to you. And so basically, I think to ask help, you know, you could always try one of the local studios here in Pensacola, and they should be able to answer any of your questions that you have. We got time for a couple more phone calls. Let's take them. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, my name's Jim, and I'd like to ask Phil, how long has he been singing?
Mm. Thank you very much, Jim.
Way back there. I've been singing for several years. I would imagine at least since 1977.
That's a pretty long time. That's 10 years, whether you know it. Boy, it doesn't seem like 77 was that long ago. Well, folks, tonight my guest is Phil Thomas Katt. And if you'd like to call in to the Katt line, tell them what number it is there, Phil.
476 Moon, or quadruple six.
Quadruple six. I tell you, it's that phone line thing. I'm going to really get into that on the future shows that are coming up and everything, because it seems like any way at all that you can promote yourself, you know, you should do it. And I think that you've taken a relatively inexpensive means and turned it into some big bucks for yourself and everything. Before we sign off, I'm going to take one more phone call at least and see what's happening. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Hey, Harry, this is Scott.
Hi, Scott.
How you doing? Hey, Phil, I was going to ask you, how do you come about on your recordings? How do you think them up, day by day, or do you write them down as you come along, think about them?
Well, I have creative periods, and I try to record a lot of messages during that time because I have dry periods. I can't think of anything, so I usually save them up when I do have good times.
Well, thanks a lot.
Keep going, though.
Thank you.
Appreciate the phone call, Scott.
All right, have a good one.
Okay, sir. You carry a cassette around with you all the time?
I'm out of the habit of doing that now. Now, I need to get back into it, personally. That's just laziness on my part. But, yeah, I do like to.
Well, it's that time again. We've already used up our 30 minutes that allotted to us here. And next week, my guest is going to be Jay Hawkins and Ken Smith from right here in Pensacola, Florida. Please tune in for another Haley's Lightning Sound Show on Blab TV on Channel 6 at 6. Thank you very much.